Hello learners, welcome to the biology series. Today's video is all about a recapitulation of biology and living entities. The term biology was coined by Lamarck and Treviranus. Well, biology is the process of studying life in a scientific way. In order to understand life on Earth, biology is an important facet of science that provides information about various life forms. For that, we need to characterize living things from non-living things. A feature that could be used to decide whether something was living or not would be called a characteristic of living things. Certain features are common to all living things. They can grow, reproduce, react to surroundings, move, excrete, obtain nutrition, respire, and are cellular. An object must possess all these characteristics to be considered living. Otherwise, it is not a living thing. As we have studied the features of living things, one of them is that all living things are made up of cells. What is cell? Cell is a basic, structural, and functional unit of life. An organism may have single or multiple cells. As the name implies, unicellular organisms are made up of a single cell, while multicellular organisms have carried many cells to perform life processes. Moving forward, let's talk about types of cells based on cellular structure. These are prokaryotic cells and eukaryotic cells. Prokaryotes are the simple, single-celled organisms that do not have a true nucleus. For example, bacteria, mycoplasma, cyanobacteria, etc. While eukaryotes are the complex, multicellular organisms that possess true nucleus, for example humans, plants, etc., are considered eukaryotes. Let's have a look at levels of structural organization in the living body. Living organisms are highly complex, ordered systems made up of single or multiple cells. The atom is the smallest and most fundamental unit of matter. The bonding of at least two atoms or more form molecules. In multicellular organisms, similar cells form tissues. Group of tissues constitute organs, and organ system is made when organs work together. When organ systems are arranged properly to complete a particular task, make up an organism. The cell theory is one of the fundamental theories of biology. This original theory was proposed by Schleiden and Schwann in 1838, which states that all living things are made up of cells and arises from pre-existing cell. Later on, the original theory was expanded by the scientists, and it was named as modern cell theory, which states that energy flow occurs within cells. Cells contain genetic material, and that all cells are essentially the same in chemical composition. Continuing ahead, let's have a brief look at scientists and their discoveries.
Take a look.
The first compound microscope was invented in 1590. In 1665, Robert Hooke redesigned the existing compound microscope. Through this microscope, he discovered cells in the piece of cork. Later on, he illustrated his observations in a book named Micrographia. After Hooke's discovery, Dutch scientist Antony van Leeuwenhoek discovered other tiny organisms. That's bacteria and protozoa. He called these tiny creatures animalcules. Marcello studied animal tissues under microscope. Nehemiah Grew described plant tissues. Fontana found nucleolus in the skin cell of eel. Robert Brown discovered nucleus. However, Schwann and Schleiden studied plants and animals' tissues, respectively, and proposed the cell theory.
Trivia time!
Do you know? There are more bacterial cells in the body of human than human cells. The largest living cell in the nature is ostrich egg. This is very much a revision or recapitulation video. Take care, and thank you for watching.